As game artists, we have to dive in layer management a lot. Krita 3 comes with an updated layers docker. It's not only its look that has changed, but a lot of functionality has been added as well. In this video, we are going to focus on everything related to the new functions, and in the next video, we will talk about layers coloring, as well as the actual filtering options you can see right in there. I'll keep the layers docker on the side of my document, just so that I can show you everything that happens in the document. The first thing that changed that's really important is that many functions now work on multiple layers selected at the same time. For instance, if I select three different layers and press Ctrl E, it will merge them. Back in Krita 2.9, this would have only merged Arthur and Jack, the first two characters. Next up, you can delete layers with the keyboard. Before, you could only delete the content of a layer with the delete key. Now you can press Shift Delete and it will delete the selected layer, all the selected layers all at once. If I select three layers and press Shift Delete, it will delete the layers as well as their content. Overall, you will be able to see that the developers focused on making the layers docker more keyboard friendly. You can navigate the layer stack with the page up and page down keys, and you can now also move layers up and down the stack by pressing Ctrl and page up or page down. If I place two characters on top of one another, like that's the case for Arthur and the Reaper, if I press Ctrl page up, you will see that the Reaper is brought to front, and if I press Ctrl page down, it is brought back to its initial position. With that function, if a group is open like that, and you have a layer below the group, when you press Ctrl page up, the layer will enter the group. However, if the group is closed, the layer will skip the group and it will move on top of the group. Then we have the ability to rename layers with the F2 key. This is a really common keyboard shortcut on your operating system, but also in many programs, so this is quite handy. The selected layer will get renamed when you press F2. And then, if you select any amount of layers and press F3, you will be able to edit their properties all at the same time. So this includes the generic layers properties, the visibility, the locking, the inherit alpha, the pass-through, which is only available for groups, and the alpha lock feature. These are the icons you can see on the side of your layers. But you will also be able to toggle the active channel on or off. You will be able to change the blending mode. We haven't talked about those yet much in the training, but this is quite useful as well, to change the opacity of all of the layers at the same time. And you will also be able to change the name of the layers. For instance, if I enter a name, Krita will give every selected layer the same name, but it will also add a number to differentiate them. This can be useful when you have multiple props of the same type, or in that case, I could say that all of these sprites are characters. And if I type in character, Krita will name the layers character 0, character 1, and character 2. In that current version I have in here, you have to check the little checkbox to edit the name, but in the next version, you will be able to just click inside of the field and it will edit it straight away. You can also assign a color label, but we will talk about that in the next video. There's something really interesting with all of those changes, which is the fact that they work really well in synergy with the new layer picking tool. The layer picking tool, which you can access with the R key, has also been improved in this version. This tool allowed you to click on a picture on some pixels on your canvas, and Krita would select the corresponding layer. Well, you can still do that, but now what you can do is, if you keep the Shift key down, Krita will add layers to your selection. You can directly select a range of layers on the canvas. Note that Krita will only select layers that are not locked. And this is quite useful to us. In that case, I'm going to lock all of the groups that make up the game's background. Now, if I keep the R key down and click on this character, Jack, it gets selected. I shift-click, I select the Reaper. But shift-clicking like that is a bit slow. Especially if I had a few dozens of characters, this wouldn't be ideal. Now, what I can do is keep the shift key down, the R key as well, and I can drag along on the canvas. And you can see that all of the layers that I drag on get added to the selection. I can then, for instance, group them all, and this is the next feature we are going to talk about. Grouping, ungrouping, and creating a clipping group. So now you have the ability to group selected layers by pressing Ctrl G. Before, it would only add an empty group. Now it puts the selected layers inside of that group. You can also ungroup layers. If you select a group and press Ctrl-Alt-G, Krita will delete the group, but it will keep the layers. Now you can also select a range of layers, press Ctrl-Alt-G, and Krita will take them out of the group they are in. There's another very useful feature that was added, which is the ability to create a quick clipping group. So this corresponds to clipping masks in a program like Photoshop, Illustrator, or Inkscape. You've probably heard of them already. A clipping mask allows you to paint on top of your layer, but without destroying the actual pixels of the underlying layers. So it's a way to paint inside the limits of your layers non-destructively. To create a clipping group, you just have to make a selection, a layer selection, and press Ctrl-Shift-G. What Krita will do is it will create a group, it will keep your original layer, and it will add a new mask layer with the alpha inherit turned off. On that layer, I can paint and it will use the alpha channel of the layers below it. You can add any amount of new layer, check the alpha channel off, and use any color to paint on top of your underlying layers. We'll talk more about alpha and alpha inheritance in a future tutorial. I told you that old functions work on multiple layers selected at the same time. Well, this also works with the Ctrl J keyboard shortcut, which allows you to duplicate the selected layers. However, you can't use the copy and cut the content of your selection to a new layer on multiple layers at the same time. You can only use that on a single layer. So if you press Ctrl Shift J, it will cut your selection to a new layer. And if you use Ctrl Alt J, it will copy your selection to a new layer, but it will preserve the original layer.